हेलो फ्रेंड, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स सर्किट हब। प्लीज लाइक शेयर एंड सब्सक्राइब माय यूट्यूब चैनल। सो टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट डिजाइन एंड सिमुलेशन ऑफ ऑपरेशनल एम्पलीफायर हाफ वेव रेक्टिफायर। ओके, सो वी विल सी द बिहेवियर ऑफ ओप एम्प हाफ वेव रेक्टिफायर। Then we will design circuit in LTSpice. Then we will see the practical behavior using LTSpice simulation, right? So let us start the theory of half wave rectifier, op amp half wave rectifier. So this is the basic circuit of op amp half wave rectifier. So this is 50 hertz sine wave signal. Okay, this is 50 hertz sine wave signal, and this is op amp. Your input is connected to the non-inverting terminal of an op amp plus terminal, and your minus terminal is connected to the output. Here RL is a load, okay, and D1 is your a diode which is connected in between output terminal of an op amp and Vout. So this is positive supply of an op amp, this is a negative supply. Okay, so for the positive supply, positive cycle, if you want to get VO1 output here, what will you get? VO1 equals to 0.7 volt plus Vout. Okay, 0.7 volt plus Vout. That means this forward voltage of diode and in addition of Vout. Okay, when your input signal is greater than zero. Okay, so what would be your output at VO1? VO1 equals to AOL into Vin, and AOL is open loop gain of an operational amplifier, which is very high in terms of 10 to the power 5 or 10 to the power 4. Okay, so if Vin equals to V plus minus V minus, okay, the voltage at positive terminal is V plus and the voltage at negative terminal is V minus, so V in equals to V plus minus V minus. Okay, so you can put the value here, 0.7 plus V out, which is coming from here, VO1 equals to AOL into V in place of V in, you can put V plus minus V minus. Okay, since AOL is very high, so if you divide by this term, divide by this term, this term divide by this term, since AOL is very high, it will be zero. Okay, so you will have only V plus minus V minus equals to zero. Okay, then V plus equals to V minus equals to V out. That means your V in equals to V out. That means since V minus equals to V out, it is connected to the V out. So you will have the same input signal at your output. Okay, when this diode is in forward wise, let us consider this diode is on and it is working in forward wise. So you will have the same output, which is equal to the input. So in this waveform, you can see for positive half cycle, you are getting the same waveform, and you are not getting anything for negative half cycle, and then again next cycle you are getting for positive half cycle. Okay, now let us see when negative for negative half cycle and negative half cycle, and when your V in is less than 0 volt. And okay, so when V in is less than 0 volt, okay, V in is less than 0 volt, that means your diode in is in reverse bias. To bias diode in reverse fashion, you need to have negative voltage at diode anode. That means VO1 equals to negative. Okay, in such a case you will get output 0 volt. Here you are getting output 0 volt, so the same output you will get at negative terminal. Okay, so in that case op-amp goes into the negative saturation region, so it will saturate near to negative power supply. And again, for the positive half cycle, since it is in negative saturation, it is having negative saturation voltage. For next positive half cycle, it will take some time to reach negative supply voltage to positive supply voltage. So the basic limitation of this circuit is that it will only work in low frequency operation, let's say 50 hertz to 100 hertz or some 200 hertz, 500 hertz, but it will not work for high frequency operation. This is the limitation of this half wave rectifier. Okay, since op-amp goes in negative saturation, and when it will come to the positive saturation, it will take some time to reach the positive voltage, so it also depend upon the op-amp slew rate, how fast your op-amp is. To avoid this limitation, we have to modify this circuit, and we will have modified circuit. In that circuit, your non-inverting terminal is connected to the ground and your inverting terminal is connected with the input voltage, and you have another diode D1 which is connected here, and you have another resistance which is feedback resistance which is connected here. This is gain resistance. Okay, so for positive half cycle, when Vin is greater than 0 volt, your output would be 0. How your output would be 0? Okay, so for the positive half cycle, this diode will conduct. Let me show you. For the positive half cycle, this diode will conduct, and this will be biased as a reverse bias. How this will be reverse bias? For positive half cycle, D1 will conduct, so you will have some forward voltage here. So if you apply KVL here, 0 minus 0.7 volt, which is equals to minus 0.7 volt, you will get at VO1. Okay, so this is more negative and this is 0 volt. So this is reverse bias and open circuit. So for the positive half cycle, your output would be 0, so you are not getting any output here. Okay, this is done. For negative half cycle, now diode D1 is in reverse bias and diode D2 conduct, and you will get an output V out equals to R2 divided by R1 into V in, and R2 divided by R1 is your gain. So in this circuit, your op-amp is not going in negative saturation region, not going in negative saturation. So it will act fastly rather than your previous circuit. Okay. So now we will simulate this circuit using LTSP. So guys, I have already drawn the schematic for op-amp half wave rectifier. So your V2 is connected to the non-inverting terminal, and your inverting terminal is connected to the op-amp output terminal, and there is diode which is connected to the your output, and this is the load resistance. This is your positive supply voltage 15 volt, and this is your negative supply voltage minus 15 volt. I've used LT1368 for my simulation, and the diode is 1N4148. Okay, so let me run the simulation and show you the behavior. Okay, so I will take two plane. One is for your input. Okay, this is for your output. Okay, So you can see here, for the positive half cycle, your V out equals to your V in, which is very closer here, 2.5 volt, and here you are getting 2.06. Okay, 2.06 volt, which is very closer to the 2.1 volt. So for the negative half cycle, here for the negative half cycle, you are not getting any voltage. So since your diode is in reverse bias, so for the positive half cycle, your diode is in forward bias, and this part shorted with output, and this circuit behaves like a voltage follower circuit. This circuit behaves like a voltage follower circuit. So whatever is your input voltage, you are getting the same output voltage at your output terminal in forward bias. So the first case we have seen, for the when Vin is greater than 0 volt, you are getting some output voltage, which is your output is follow to the input. And when your Vin is less than 0 volt, Vin is less than here 0 volt, you are not getting any volt, and it is only 0 volt. Okay, so let me run this circuit for, let's say, 10 kilohertz signal, and let us see the behavior. You have to reduce the time period here. For 10 kilohertz, it is 1 millisecond. Let me run the simulation. Okay, let me show you the behavior. Now you can see you are not getting any output voltage, which is desired output voltage, which should be in good shape, and the desired amplitude. For positive half cycle, you are not getting anything. For negative half cycle, you are not getting any fit. This is because of your opium goes in negative saturation. Okay, as discussed earlier, to nullify, to overcome this problem, we have to look for the second circuit. So this is your second circuit. In second circuit, your non-inverting terminal is connected to the ground. You have given your input signal to your inverting terminal, which is 2.5 volt peak and 1 kilohertz. In previous circuit, you have given the frequency of 50 hertz. Here we will see the behavior while using the frequency of 1 kilohertz. So here your gain is R1 divided by R2 minus R1 divided by R2, which is 4.1 volt. So for input 2.5 volt, your output would be 10 volt around, minus 10 volt. Okay, as per this formula. So let me run the simulation. Then your one more diode is connected between here, your output terminal of an op-amp and negative terminal, and your feedback resistor is connected after D1. And this is the load, and this is the supply, positive supply, and this is the negative supply. So let me run the simulation. So I will take two plane. So this is your input and this is your output. Okay, let me change the color. Okay, now you can see your input is 2.5 volt peak and you are getting around 10 volt your output, because you have given an amplification factor of 4. So your output is multiplied by 4. So for input 2.5 volt, you are getting 10 volt here. Okay, and one more thing you can see here, if I click here and I will show you. Okay, now you can see the behavior. For positive half cycle, you are getting 0 volt. For negative half cycle, you are getting 10 volt. Again, for positive half cycle, you are getting 0 volt, and for negative half cycle, you are getting 10 volt. Okay, so this works at frequency of 1 kilohertz. Even if you increase the frequency, you will see the behavior. Okay, so thanks for watching